this video, I want to walk you through the difference between a confidence level and a confidence interval. So if you're getting started doing data analysis or statistics, you want to make sure that you're not using these two words interchangeably because they mean very, very different things. So first, let's talk about a confidence level. A confidence level is essentially the probability that a true population parameter fits within the confidence interval established by a study. So another way to kind of say that is that your confidence level is the percentage of times that if you took a random sampling, you would come out to a mean for a specific parameter that you're investigating that is within the confidence interval of your study. And so that can be a little bit of difficult to kind of grasp your head around. Our confidence level essentially relates to what is the likelihood that we're going to replicate these results given a randomized sample. So if we didn't pull those exact same specimens again, but we pulled completely new ones from the same population, what's the confidence that we would get a specific result? And so some of the most common confidence intervals are 95%, which often corresponds to a p-value of 0.05, 99%, which corresponds to a p-value of 0.01, and 99.9%, which is a p-value of 0.001. And so what this is saying is if you have a 95% confidence level, that means that if you take a randomized sample, there's a 95% chance that the mean of that sample is going to be within your confidence interval of the study you just ran. Your confidence interval is a range around this sample mean that's going to be representative of where the majority of randomized samples' means would fall. A confidence interval is written as the sample mean plus or minus the confidence level value times the standard deviation of the sample divided by the number of samples that you did. So if you want to have a tighter confidence interval or become more precise with your confidence interval, you have three things that you can alter to create a more precise confidence interval. The first one is your confidence level. If you increase your confidence level, you're going to decrease the number that you're plusing or minusing from your mean. So that means you're going to have a tighter range. But what that also means is once you decrease that confidence level, you're not going to be as representative. So if you go from 99%, which is going to have a wider confidence interval, to 95%, which will have a smaller confidence interval, but you're only going to be representative 95% of the time versus 99% of the time. So it really matters what type of study you're doing and what confidence level really makes sense for that study. The two other characteristics that you can alter is your standard deviation. You have a chance of being able to decrease the standard deviation of your sample if you can identify confounding variables that you can eliminate. Confounding variables are going to be things that increase the standard deviation of your sample but aren't related to the specific experiment you're studying. So if you can find those and eliminate them, you can actually decrease your confidence interval and become more precise. And then the final thing you can do is increase your sample size. This is probably one of the easiest ways to make your confidence interval more precise without messing with your confidence level. And that's just by increasing the number of samples. That means you're now observing more of your population, which means you're more likely to arrive at a correct mean for that. So those are the basics of the difference between your confidence level, which is about how reproducible is your confidence interval. And then your confidence interval is the range that means would fall in if you redid your sample over and over again. If you are just getting started and learning these terms so that you can get them right, but you're struggling in coming up with your new research idea, I suggest you download my 30-day research jumpstart guide. It's going to help you to find your idea, learn your field, and start collecting data. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one.